Hello, welcome to my channel, where we explore the fascinating world of aviation. Today, we will discuss one of the most iconic and versatile jet fighters of the Cold War, the Douglas A-4 Skyhawk. The Skyhawk was designed and produced by the American company Douglas Aircraft and later by McDonnell Douglas in the 1950s. It was a single-seat, subsonic carrier-capable light attack aircraft that could also perform fighter and adversary roles. It was originally developed for the U.S. Navy and Marine Corps to replace the piston-powered Douglas AD-Sky Raider. The Skyhawk was a remarkable aircraft for its time. It was small, simple, and lightweight, weighing only half of the Navy's weight specification. It had a short-span delta wing that did not need to fold for carrier storage, a single turbojet engine that could be easily accessed and replaced, and a minimalistic design that reduced complexity and cost. It could carry a bomb load equivalent to a World War I-era Boeing B-17 bomber and deliver nuclear weapons using a low-altitude bombing system and a loft delivery technique. It also pioneered the buddy air-to-air refueling, allowing an aircraft to supply others and reduce the need for dedicated tanker aircraft. The Skyhawk was in production until 1979, with almost 3,000 aircraft built, including 555 to-seat trainers. It served with many air forces and navies worldwide, especially those with smaller or older aircraft carriers that could not operate larger and heavier fighters. The Skyhawk saw combat action in several conflicts, such as the Vietnam War, the Yom Kippur War, the Falklands War, and Operation Desert Storm. It also became famous as the aircraft of the Blue Angels, the U.S. Navy's aerobatic team. From 1974 to 1986, the Skyhawk was well-loved by its pilots and crews for being tough and agile. It earned many nicknames, such as Scooter, Kitty Car, Bantam Bomber, Tinker Toy Bomber, and Heinemann's Hot Rod, after its designer, Ed Heinemann. The Skyhawk remained in service for decades despite being replaced by newer and more advanced aircraft in some roles. Air forces and navies used it for training and adversary roles until the early 2000s. Some Skyhawks are still flying today with private contractors or in museums. This video will closely examine the Skyhawk's development, variants, operators, and combat history. If you are interested in this topic, please subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. Let's get started. The Skyhawk was born out of a challenge, designing a jet-powered attack aircraft that could replace the old piston-engine Skyraider and operate from the Navy's aircraft carriers. The man who took up this challenge was Ed Heinemann, a brilliant engineer who worked for Douglas Aircraft Company. He devised a radical solution, a small, simple, lightweight aircraft weighing only half of the Navy's weight specification. He called it the A-4D Skyhawk. The Skyhawk was sleek and compact, with a short-span delta wing that did not need to fold for carrier storage. It had a single turbojet engine that could be easily accessed and replaced by removing the rear fuselage. It had minimal folding or retracting mechanisms, saving weight and space. It had two 20mm cannons in the wing roots and five hardpoints for carrying bombs, rockets, missiles, and nuclear weapons. It also pioneered the buddy air-to-air refueling, allowing one Skyhawk to refuel another in flight. The Skyhawk flew on June 22, 1954, and set a world speed record of 695 miles per hour on October 15, 1955. It entered service with the U.S. Navy and Marine Corps on October 1, 1956, and became a versatile and reliable aircraft. The Skyhawk was produced in many variants and improvements, such as the A-4E, which had a more powerful engine and an improved avionics suite, the A-4F, which had a dorsal hump containing extra electronics, and the A-4M, which was optimized for the Marine Corps with enhanced cockpit visibility and more payload capacity. The Skyhawk remained in production until 1979, with almost 3,000 aircraft built for various operators worldwide. The Skyhawk made its combat debut in the Vietnam War, where it served as the main light attack aircraft for both the U.S. Navy and the Marine Corps. Flying from aircraft carriers and land bases, the Skyhawk carried out various missions, such as bombing, close air support, interdiction, and air-to-air refueling. The Skyhawk could deliver highly accurate conventional and nuclear weapons and refuel other aircraft using a buddy system. However, the Skyhawk also faced many challenges and dangers in the war. The Skyhawk pilots had to deal with intense anti-aircraft fire, surface-to-air missiles, enemy fighters, and difficult carrier landings. Many Skyhawks were shot down or damaged by enemy fire, and some pilots were captured or killed, John McCain was shot down over Hanoi in 1967 and spent 5.5 years as a POW. He later became a U.S. senator and a presidential candidate. Everett Alvarez Jr. was the first U.S. Navy pilot to be shot down and captured in 1964. He spent 8.5 years as a POW, the longest among American aviators. Michael Estosen was posthumously awarded the Medal of Honor for his actions while flying surface-to-air missile suppression missions in 1967. He was shot down and killed on his second mission of the day. Theodore Swartz, who shot down a MiG-17 with an unguided rocket in 1970. The only air-to-air victory by a Skyhawk in the war, the USS Forrestal fire was caused by a Zuni rocket misfire that hit a Skyhawk's fuel tank in 1967. The fire killed 134 sailors, injured 161, and destroyed or damaged 21 aircraft. The Skyhawk was a tough and agile aircraft that performed well in the war. It was also well-loved by its crews for being easy to fly and maintain. The Skyhawk remained in service until the war's end, flying over 360,000 sorties and losing 362 aircraft to all causes. The Skyhawk was a success in the U.S. and a popular export product for many countries worldwide. The Skyhawk's small size, low cost, high payload, and maneuverability made it an attractive choice for air forces and navies that needed a light attack aircraft, especially those with smaller or older aircraft carriers that could not operate larger and heavier fighters. The Skyhawk was also adaptable and adjustable to suit other customers' different needs and preferences. Israel was the largest export customer for the Skyhawk, buying 217 A-4s from the US and 46 from other sources. The Skyhawk was named Eagle in Israeli service and became the main ground attack aircraft for the Israeli Air Force. The Skyhawk saw combat action in several conflicts, such as the War of Attrition, the Yom Kippur War, and the 1980 to Lebanon War. The Skyhawk was well loved by its pilots and crews for being tough and agile. It also shot down several enemy aircraft, including MiG-17S and MiG-21S. The Skyhawk remained in service until 2015, when it was retired from the IAF. Argentina was the first foreign user of the Skyhawk, acquiring 130 A-4s since 1965. The Argentine Air Force and the Navy used the Skyhawk as their primary light attack aircraft. The Skyhawk played a key role in the 1980 to Falklands War, attacking British ships and land targets with unguided bombs. The Skyhawk sank two British frigates and damaged several others, but also suffered heavy losses from anti-aircraft fire, missiles, and fighters. After the war, Argentina upgraded some of its Skyhawks to the A-4R Fighting Hawk standard, with improved avionics and weapons. The A-4R is still in service as of 2021. Kuwait purchased 36 built Skyhawks in 1974, including 30 single-seat A-4Cs and 6 two-seat TA-4Cs. The Kuwaiti Air Force used the Skyhawks as their main fighter-bomber aircraft. Skyhawk participated in Operation Desert Storm, defending Kuwait from the Iraqi invasion. The Skyhawks attacked Iraqi ground forces, heli, helicopters, Andre, and capture. 24 of the surviving Skyhawks escaped to Saudi Arabia. They formed the Free Kuwait Air Force, flying over 1,300 sorties during the liberation of Kuwait. In 1998, Kuwait sold its remaining Skyhawks to Brazil. Australia bought 20 A-4Gs in 1967 for per aircraft carrier Hamas Melbourne. The A-4Gs were mainly used to provide air defense for the fleet but also performed other missions such as surveillance, and the rest were sold to New Zealand in 1984. New Zealand ordered 14 Skyhawks in 1970, including 10 single-seat A-4Ks. The Royal New Zealand Air Force operated the Skyhawks. In 1983, New Zealand bought 8 more A-4Gs from Australia to form a second squadron. In 1986, New Zealand launched Project Kahu to upgrade its Skyhawks with new radar, avionics, and weapons. The upgraded Skyhawks were designated a 4K Hawk. The Skyhawks were used for training and other services for various air forces and navies, including Australia and the US. In 2001, the Skyhawks were retired and put into storage awaiting sale. Some of them were later sold to a private contractor in the US. Indonesia bought 32 A-4Es from Israel in 1979 through a covert operation, since both countries did not have diplomatic relations. The Indonesian Air Force used the A-4Es as the main fighter-bomber aircraft. In 1982, Indonesia purchased another 15 A-4Es from U.S. stocks as spare parts sources. the A-4ES were allegedly involved in combat operations against separatist forces in East Timor and Aceh during the 1980s and 1992. By 1999, only 19 A-4ES were left operational due to maintenance issues and accidents. In 2003, Indonesia replaced its A-4ES with Sukhoi Su-27S, Malaysia acquired 80 refurbished A-4Cs and A-4LS from U.S. stocks in 1982, a Parasitana program. 40 were with a new bombing system, air refueling capability, increased payload, and redesignated as a A-4 to Malaysia. The rest were kept as reserve and spare parts sources. The A-4 PTMs were used by the Royal Malaysian Air Force as their main ground attack aircraft. In 1995, the A-4 PTMs were retired and replaced by the Bi-Systems Hawk. Brazil is the latest and current Skyhawk customer. In 1997, Brazil negotiated a $70 million contract for the TOW to purchase tools from Cutools. The Skyhawks were modified A-4 MiS that had been delivered to Kuwait in 1977. The Skyhawks were renamed a F-1 and F-1A Falcons in Brazilian service and used by the Brazilian Navy from its naval craft carrier São Paulo. In 2009, Embraer signed a contract to modernize 12 Brazilian Navy Skyhawks with new radar, avionics, and systems. The first and the modified Skyhawks was delivered in 2015. The Skyhawks are still in service as of 2021. As you can see, the Skyhawk was a versatile and reliable aircraft that served in many countries and conflicts worldwide. The Skyhawk was a remarkable aircraft that remained in service for decades despite being replaced by newer and more advanced aircraft in some roles. It was also used for training and adversary roles by various air forces and navies, providing a valuable platform for teaching and challenging future fighter pilots. Project Kahu in New Zealand is a program that upgraded 22 runs of Skyhawks with new radar, avionics, and weapons based on the F-16E's systems. The upgraded Skyhawks were a 4K Hawk and served until 2001 when they were retired and put into storage. Some of them were later sold to a private contractor in the US. Fighting Hawk in Argentina is a version of the Skyhawk that was rebuilt and modernized by Lockheed Martin for the Argentine Air Force. The Fighting Hawk was based on the A-4M model used by the US Marine Corps. However, with improvements, used duction, oxygen gene oxygen generating Fighting Hawk entered service in the late 1990s and is still in service as of 2021. Draken International in the US is a private company that provides adversary training services to the US military and other customers. Draken International bought 8 A-4Ks from New Zealand in 2012, along with spare parts and equipment. The company operates the Skyhawks from its base in Florida, where they fly against US fighter jets in simulated combat scenarios. Embraer in Brazil is a Brazilian aerospace company that signed a contract to modernize 12 Brazilian Navy Skyhawks in 2009. The company upgraded the Skyhawks with new radar, avionics, and systems, making them compatible with the Brazilian aircraft carrier São Paulo. The first of the modified Skyhawks was delivered in 2015. The Skyhawks are still in service as of 2021. In conclusion, the Skyhawk was a significant and influential aircraft in aviation history. It was a simple but effective design that could perform multiple roles and adapt to different needs and preferences. It was a versatile and reliable aircraft that served in many countries and conflicts worldwide. It was also tough, and accolades from its pilots and crews. The Skyhawk was truly an amazing aircraft that deserves our respect and admiration. We hope you enjoyed this video about the Douglas A-4 Skyhawk. If you did, please give us a thumbs up, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to our channel for more amazing aircraft videos. Also, remember to leave your comments below and let us know what you think about the Skyhawk or any other aircraft you want us to cover. Thank you for watching.